Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the March 1st, 2021 meeting of the Senate's Committee on Investigations and Government Operations. I'm the chair of the committee, James Skoufis, and I believe I'm joined with all of our committee members today, and I'll go through them. First, our ranking member, Senator O'Mara, as well as Senators Gorin, Kaminsky, Reichland Melnick, Palumbo, and Biagi. I want to welcome everybody. Before we get to our, I believe it's a 13-bill agenda, it's my understanding that Senator O'Mara has some political theater for us to first take up. So I will hand it over to him to make a motion.
If you want to state that 15,000 nursing home deaths is political theater, that's your opinion, Chairman Skoufis. It's not mine. You have repeatedly called for subpoenas and an investigation into the nursing home fatalities throughout this pandemic. Yet this committee has the authority to issue subpoenas and individuals to testify. I have served a notice of motion with an attached draft subpoena pursuant to Legislative Law 62A of the State of New York, requesting that a subpoena be issued for the Health Commissioner Howard Zucker to testify before this committee on March 8th and produce all records relative to communications between his office and the executive office on correspondence, communications regarding the deaths within nursing homes and healthcare facilities, with regards to the FOIL request of the Empire Center that has been highly publicized and stonewalled for 7 months. In fact, on February 19th, the governor himself said in his press conference, his exact words were, "Why didn't you send a subpoena? If you really wanted it, that's what you have done, would have done." This is my second request of this committee to issue a subpoena to Howard Zucker requesting this important information for our Investigations and Governmental Operations Committee to be involved with. That's my motion. I'm looking for a second.
Chairman, if I may be heard?
Absolutely.
Thank you. And I second Senator O'Mara's motion. And of course, we do take exception to the fact that you characterize this as political theater. And I do. We did this a couple of weeks ago, and you had indicated that you felt that we were being political and ambushed you. And I'm sorry that you feel that way, because this is simply an investigative information seeking mission here. When we've got, obviously we're not making specific, we're not convicting anyone, we're not making specific allegations of criminal conduct at this point, but very simply, what could it hurt? Because we know that the administration has intentionally refused to comply with FOIL requests. That's a given, and that's been admitted. We have Commissioner Zucker last week indicating and hiding behind a federal investigation that he's not necessarily even a target in. We had 3 minutes to ask questions. That's certainly not enough time to vet these things. So at the end of the day, look, Chairman, you and I have known each other for many years. You've been very aggressive in this committee, as you indicated when we made a motion a few weeks ago, that you continue to issue these subpoenas, and they're for informational purposes at this point. So other than the fact that we do have confidential investigations ongoing with the federal, with the Eastern District, from what I understand, who knows to what extent that will be going on. We have other allegations that have nothing to do with COVID now that are being dealt with by the Attorney General and the governor. But quite frankly, this is simply a request for information, all of the information, because we know that they've stonewalled. So I certainly second this motion, and I don't see any reasons other than political not to sign such a subpoena, quite frankly. So thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak, Chairman.
Of course. Thanks very much. And so I will be ruling the motion out of order pursuant to Rule 7, Section 2. And let me say, there are issues with both process here as well as substance, and I'll outline briefly both of them. First, on process, Section 2 requires that new agenda items must be published at least 24 hours prior to the committee taking up the agenda. While Senator O'Mara did send over the motion in writing, unlike the previous attempt a couple of weeks ago, it was only received about an hour, hour and a half ago, I believe, and thus is in violation of that section of our Senate rules. Furthermore, more broadly, the chair decides all procedural issues which arise during meetings of standing committees like this one. And so on process, there remain issues. Let me speak about substance very briefly. Senator Mara, just in response to your remark that I have threatened subpoenas. Yes, at the end of January, I threatened subpoenas, a subpoena, to receive the full data, the number of nursing home deaths of those residents who passed away in hospitals. I believe in part because of those remarks that I made, a couple of weeks later, we received the full nursing home deaths. I don't know if perhaps you understand what a subpoena is used for, but a subpoena is used for getting information or testimony that you're seeking that you do not receive. The issue that I threatened the subpoena for, we received that information. But more importantly and broadly speaking, to your motion, there is, and Senator Palumbo rightly acknowledged this, there are ongoing FBI and Department of Justice investigations into this very matter. And your motion to try and find, you know, some criminal impropriety in emails or text messages is far beyond the bounds of the jurisdiction of this committee. We cannot indict people. We cannot arrest people. We do not engage in criminal investigations. Furthermore, to that end, I have full faith, and I believe the majority of this committee has full faith in the men and women in law enforcement who are conducting these federal investigations. What you are suggesting is that we interfere with those federal ongoing investigations, which I am absolutely not going to allow this committee to do. So you may no doubt make subsequent motions and subsequent committee meetings after today. You will receive this same response on the substance. And that is, while you were trying to respectfully, you are trying to undermine the federal investigations with your motion, the majority of this committee will be supporting the FBI and DOJ in their efforts. And so for all of those reasons, I'm ruling your motion out of order, Senator O'Mara.
I would move the ruling of the chair and ask that I be heard in response.
You can proceed.
This has absolutely nothing to do with a federal or DOJ or Attorney General investigation. This has everything to do with our governmental oversight, which is the prime objective of this committee, to determine why the executive and why the Department of Health has refused in Stonewall to provide this legislature with information that we've requested now for nearly a year. That the only reason that this information was turned over, Chairman, was not because you mentioned you might maybe introduce or issue subpoenas. It was because a court ordered it, that they provide it to the Empire Center. It has nothing to do with your threat of a subpoena, because right now your threat of a subpoena means nothing. I respectfully request that we overturn the ruling of the chair.
Okay, before we proceed with the vote, any other comments from committee members? Okay, seeing none, I'll just remind the committee that the motion is to overrule the chair. And so a no vote will be to reject the motion to overrule the chair. And that is what I'll be recommending. And so with that, is there anything else, Nick Rengel, procedurally before I move forward with the vote?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. So all those in favor of overruling, say aye.
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 Senator O'Mara, Senator Palumbo, all those against?
No.
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 And no. So the motion fails. Senator O'Mara, the motion is lost because the ruling of the chair requires a majority of the members to vote in favor of overruling the chair. Now the ruling of the chair stands. Unless there are further comments on this particular matter from other committee members, we'll proceed with the agenda. Okay, hearing none, let's jump in now. The first bill is S-1625.
S-1625, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the public officers law in relation to amending the definition of public body.
I'll make the motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Senator Gorin seconds.
I have a question. So what types of public bodies in general does this impact?
So I'll let council speak to details, but there are a number of commissions, task forces, et cetera, that are set up either through regs or through statute that we believe are not subject to all of the open meetings laws, for example. And I'll let Gabe or someone else at council elaborate if you'd like to.
Senator. No, that's fine. I'm good with it.
Okay. So we have a motion to second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. The motion passes. The next bill is S-1677.
S-1677, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to direct the Department of State to study, evaluate, and make recommendations concerning studies directed by the legislature to be completed.
I'll make the motion. Is there a second?
I have a question.
Senator Biagi, Senator O'Mara, question.
So we're directing the state to do a study of why they don't complete the studies that we order?
That's right. So we're directing the Department of State to examine the multitude of studies and evaluations that the houses pass. Basically, every year we pass a whole number of these. I, in my 9 years in the state legislature, I don't know that I can tell you that I've seen the results of even a single one of those studies. They cost money. They cost, you know, the resources in terms of manpower at the various agencies. And so this directs the Department of State to basically evaluate the efficacy of all of these study bills that pass the Senate and the Assembly each year.
Since the executive continues to ignore our demands for studies in a variety of areas, and I agree with you, in our authority of this committee, then I would suggest that we issue subpoenas and follow up to all these studies to find out where they stand, what they've done, all records, what they've done to promote and move forward on these studies to see if they're doing anything in response to demands of this legislature.
Yeah, and perhaps something that this committee will consider. Whereas these study bills have passed for not just years but decades, whereas the previous Republican majorities did not issue subpoenas, I find it interesting that you now suddenly are interested in this body, in this chamber, finding out more about these studies. But perhaps that is something we can consider down the road.
Chairman, if you profess to be so interested in the outcome of these studies, then I would think you would get serious about it and actually investigate it rather than just continuing this political theater nonsense.
Duly noted, Senator O'Mara. I know you're very upset about your motion from before, but duly noted. We have a motion and a second. All in favor? Aye. Any opposed?
Aye. Without rec.
Without rec, the motion carries. Next bill is S-1745.
S-1745, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the alcoholic beverage control law in relation to establishing a temporary New York craft beverage permit, and this will be referred to finance.
I'll move the bill.
Okay, we have a motion. I'll second it. I'll remind the committee, this passed the full Senate last year. Hopefully the Assembly will move it this year. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Without rec, the motion carries. The bill's referred to finance. The next is S-1803A.
S-1803A, sponsored by Senator Borello, an act in relation to granting on-premises alcohol retailers an extension of 1 year to renew their expired liquor license without any late fees during the COVID-19 state disaster emergency.
I'll make the bill.
Okay, Senator O'Mara moves the bill. I'll second it. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed or without rec? Motion carries. Next is S-1827.
S-1827, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law in relation to allowing for the sale of liquor and or wine for off-premises consumption on Christmas Day.
I'll make the motion. Is there a second? See a second from Senator Biagi. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Without rec, the motion carries. Next is S-1958.
S-1958, sponsored by Senator Krueger, an act to amend the executive law in relation to clarifying that workers shall not be punished or subjected to discipline by employers for lawful absences.
I'll make a motion. I see a second from Senator Gorin. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Without rec?
Without rec.
Okay, two without rec. The motion carries. Next is S-3180.
S-3180, sponsored by Senator May, an act in relation to directing the state liquor authority to extend liquor license for on-premise alcohol retailers for a period of 1 year.
I'll make the motion, second by Senator O'Mara. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Without rec? Motion carries. Next, S-3395.
S-3395, sponsored by Senator Gennaris, an act to amend the executive law in relation to the definition of employer for purposes of the human rights law.
Is there a motion? Senator Biagi, second by Senator Gorin. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? And without rec?
Negative.
Mr. Chairman,
negative from Senator O'Mara. Sorry, Senator Biagi?
May I make a comment?
Yeah,
about
of course.
That?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm very, very excited that this bill is moving past committee today, mainly because our expansion of the definition of employer in the human rights law is essential in order to make sure that it includes people like us when we are talking about issues of sexual harassment or abuse in the workplace, because currently the definition of employer does not include members of the legislature. And so even though this was part of the package in 2019, it did get cut in the 11th hour, as unfortunately things do sometimes in Albany, but I am very grateful that Senator Gennaris has picked up this bill with Assemblywoman Yulee New, and this will make a massive difference in the culture shift that we need to make sure that we eliminate harassment and abuse in Albany for good. So thank you.
You're here. And thank you for your leadership on this very issue. And you said it very well, and that's why we're moving the bill out of committee. So I think we have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Actually, we did this already. Senator O'Mara was opposed. Senator Palumbo?
I'm aye.
You're up.
Aye.
Okay, very good. The motion carries. The next bill is S-3971.
S-3971, sponsored by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law in relation to the registration of kegs.
Move the bill.
Moved by Senator Gorin. I'll second it. Is there any discussion? All in favor?
If I could just ask on it, kegs are currently registered, is my understanding. How is this, what is this doing differently?
Gabe, can you speak to this?
So this is specifically to set up a system by which we register who it is that purchased a keg, and then they make sure that they return it. This is actually something that was in state law between 2003 and 2011, and then was not continued. So basically the bill is you get a keg, the keg has to have some sort of tag attached, the information of the person of who owns the keg, and then the person who is purchasing the keg has to file a form that the store will keep in hand saying who are they, verifying their age and the location they live in. There is also an additional registration fee that has to be paid specific to this new form. And that deposit gets returned when the person returns the keg. If they fail to return it or don't return it within 30 days, they forfeit that $50 deposit.
Is there a fee that you mentioned that does not get returned?
No, there is no fee that does not get returned. But if you don't return the keg or fail to return it within 30 days, you don't get the fee back. Also, if you damage the tag or in some way destroy the tag that identifies the keg. In that case, the fee is also forfeit.
This sounds fairly familiar to something that we had in place. I guess you're saying that requirement has sunset. I mean,
yes,
it's been a while since I bought a keg, unfortunately, I guess. But I remember the last time I did, it had a piece of paper taped in a plastic envelope on the side of it.
You are correct, Senator. That was the law between 2003 and 2011. And at that point, it sunset and was not continued. So this is an attempt to bring back that sunset provision.
Thank you.
Okay, we have a motion and second. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Without
rec, please.
Without rec, Senator Palumbo. The motion carries. Next, S4090.
S4090, sponsored by Senator Hinchey, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law in relation to the definition of New York State labeled beer.
I'll make a motion. Is there a second? Senator Gorin seconds. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? And without rec, motion carries. Next, S4704.
S4704, sponsored by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the public officers law in relation to requiring that minutes of meetings of a public body be posted on its website.
Is there a motion? Senator Biagi, second. Senator Reichland Melnick, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Without rec.
Without
rec, Senator Palumbo,
the motion, without rec.
And Senator O'Mara, motion carries. Next, S5063.
S5063, sponsored by Senator Jackson, an act to amend the executive law in relation to prohibiting employers from discriminating against individuals based on such individual's status as a caregiver.
I'll make a motion. Is there a second? Senator Biagi, any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec?
Opposed. Opposed.
Senator O'Mara is a no. Senator Palumbo, is that AWR?
Yes.
Okay. The motion carries. And we've made it to the end here. Last but certainly not least, S5064.
S5064, sponsored by Senator Ramos, an act to amend the executive law in relation to the definition of the term employee for purposes of the human rights law, and to repeal section 296-B of the executive law relating to unlawful discriminatory practices relating to domestic workers.
As you can probably tell, we're teeing up a little bit of a Senate package here. There's a recurring theme with some of these bills. I'll make a motion. Is there a second? Senator Biagi seconds. Any discussion? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Any without rec?
Without rec, please.
Without rec.
Two without rec. The motion carries. That concludes our agenda. I want to thank everyone for their participation in the committee meeting today and look forward to our next one. I'll see you on the floor. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.